So Sabkushal Mangal is a very light-hearted comedy film and very light on the gender and basically on the marriage thing. So people who are going to go and watch the film are going to feel it's going to tickle their funny bone. And जो हम एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं कि एक फिल्म देखने जाए तो हमें एंटरटेनमेंट मिलना चाहिए, हमें हंसी आनी चाहिए, वैसी फिल्म ही है. सो आई एम प्लेइंग द गर्ल्स ब्रदर एंड बिकॉज ऑफ हुम द होल ट्विस्ट हैपेंस एंड कॉमेडी नेवर डन बिफोर. सो फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इट्स माई अटेम्प्ट टू डू अ कॉमेडी एंड वेरी डिफरेंट एक्सपीरियंस एंड लर्न अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स एंड वर्क विद वेटरन एक्टर्स लाइक राकेश जी, सतीश जी, सुप्रिया पाठक जी. सो been great experience.
And when we talk about films, you know, after a long time you are coming into a films, you know, it took a kind of break. What made you wait so long?
Actually, it didn't take a I did I had not taken a break purposely. It happened on its own. Like I was looking out for a good role. I was looking out for good TV shows. But some were working out, some were not working out. Things what I wanted to do were not working out. Things which I didn't want to do were working out. So things were not falling in place. And finally, Sabkushal Mangal came to me, and it just clicked. I gave a screen test, and it just clicked. And it happened to be all perfect. And the film is completely shot and about to release in the next 10 days. So that's how it is.
And 2020 is one more film coming up from your side, if you
Yeah.
can tell us about that as well.
Second film which is coming up is definitely one of the biggest films of Bollywood, and I'm very honored to be a part, and it's a dream to be a part of such a big project. It's called Suryavanshi, and of course Rohit sir, every actor dreams to work with Rohit sir, knowing that he's the best in action and one of the best filmmakers ever and a fantastic human being. Look, I was looking forward to work with him, and when it clicked, it was just like miracles do happen. New things to learn from him, a different kind of passion towards action, a different kind of approach towards the script, which I saw, and the kind of dedication which Akshay sir, Ajay sir, and Ranveer has was phenomenal.
And also Rohit Shetty, what do you want to say on them?
He's a man of few words. That's why he's called the best action director, and he believes in action. So the same thing, he is mostly no mostly does prefer an action and speaks less on set also. But whatever he does is keeps a very positive and very wonderful environment around the set and keeps that high energy voltage area over there.
So now that you are, you know, coming up with two films back to back, can we say that now we are not going to take any break forward and we are going to see you more on films?
I hope and I pray that the flow keeps on going and I keep doing films and of course not quit television because I feel my recognition is because of television and all due respect to it, I am here because of the TV. And I, of course, every actor aspires to take the next step. So Bollywood is the next step, and hoping that how things have surprised me in 2019, 2020 brings a lot of surprises.
Any besides this, any project you're in
Not
talks
yet,
or?
but I'm in talks with a lot of projects, including a OTT platform. So hoping that something great works out and I can reveal it out to my fans very soon.
Okay, so talking about Bigg Boss, you know, the things, the chaos which has been happening in Rashmi's life inside the house, you know, about Arhaan, how much do you know and how much is the fact that Arhaan, whatever he is doing and जो भी उनके भाई ने बोला है, how much is that true?
See, talking straight to the point, I only knew that Arhaan and Rashmi are good friends from Rashmi in herself. I have always known that they share a good rapport. That's it. These three things which I knew, I've just said. Whatever has come out on screen, in front on the national television, has been a shocker for me also, and I've been zapped hearing it. So, talking more about Arhaan is better than I talk more about my sister right now, who's in a situation over there, and I don't know what she's going through, what she's facing right now inside the house. She doesn't know what people are perceiving her or seeing this from outside the house and what she's thinking inside the house. So right now my bigger concern will be talking to my sister rather than commenting or talking about an ex-person.
But when Arhaan went inside the house again, he was supposed to get married to, you know, he planned some kind of marriage in his mind, and he went inside the house and he wanted to get married to Rashmi. But, you know, after his brother went inside and he told her that, no, don't think about it. But after, even after that, and even after Salman Khan saying Rashmi to be aware, Rashmi somewhere or the other is on a same track with Arhaan. What's the reason behind that, do you feel?
I genuinely don't know. And I would want to know it from Rashmi, that after Gaurav explaining her, she's still not... is what I got to know, that she's still on the same path. I would want to talk to Rashmi once, and I would want to understand that what's in her mind, what's in her heart regarding Arhaan, regarding the show, regarding her life, regarding Siddharth, whatever is happening in the house. I would want to know that from her. I need 5 minutes with Rashmi alone if I can get a chance to talk to her.
And Rashmi is totally different. What we know Rashmi, she is totally different inside. The things are happening with Siddharth also. So what do you want to say on the relationship of Siddharth and Rashmi?
Regarding relationship of Siddharth and Rashmi, I only knew that they are good co-actors and they share a professional co-actor relationship on set of the show which they did. There is nothing more than that, because I already had spoken to Rashmi about it, and I had said that there are news coming up between them. She said that it's because of the co-actor thing and sharing the same screen space and playing husband-wife. And because their chemistry was seen on screen, people assumed and thought and commented that they might be having more than that. So that's all about it. And then after that day, we have not spoken on it. And I think so, there is some rumors are baseless, and I think so we should not focus on that.
And Siddharth ne jo unko kaha tha that, you know, tere jaise ladki ko main ghar mein aane
nahi. I am completely against that, what he said. I am completely, and nobody has given him a right to speak to anybody like that, because he should have that much sensibility that he's speaking it on national television, and he's raising a finger at a girl's character and a girl's persona who's been followed and whom a lot of people think she is an idol for them. So without thinking about where a person is standing and just speaking out doesn't make sense for me.
This statement that she is playing a woman card, how much do you agree with this?
I've said this previously also, and I say it again and again. What is this woman card? I don't understand. Is it like some credit card that a girl plays and she gets a credit? So a girl cries, a girl speaks out her heart, and if that is the woman card, then I'm afraid that any human is not allowed to express in Bigg Boss house, or any man is not allowed to speak and express their thoughts in the Bigg Boss house. Then there should be a man card also. Why it's only a woman card?
Lekin, you know, Rashmi was expecting wherein Aarti unka saath degi, jahan par wo unko best friend maanti thi, par Aarti ne unka saath nahi diya. Aur kal hue jhagde mein Aarti ne ye kaha ki main national television par ye sari baatein nahi karna chahti. Main bahar jaake is sab cheezon ke bare mein baat karungi. Do you think Aarti ko wahan pe Rashmi ka saath dena chahiye?
I genuinely have not seen the episode, but if Aarti has done that, Aarti must have thought about her relationship with Siddharth and Rashmi both. And that's why she must have taken that stand, that she didn't want to spoil the relationship with Aarti also and Siddharth also. So somewhere down the line, I feel that it had a sensible decision of not going left and not going right and just balancing it. That's why she must have not spoken about it.
Rashmi both is short tempered.
She is not short-tempered, but situations like that, and you're in the house from last 4 weeks, I think. So now it's been almost 12 weeks. You're reaching close to 12 weeks. So that irritation of inside being a one-to-one closure, and people trying to poke you, people trying to irritate you, people trying to get you frustrated, has made her short tempered, but Rashmi is actually not a short tempered girl.
Okay, so if you get a chance to get inside the house and talk to Rashmi and give some advice, what are the advice?
There is no advice, there is only one suggestion, that just play the game the way you are, you want to play. Just keep that dignity, self-respect, and fight for the right and stand against the wrong. That's it. That is going to be seen on screen, and that is what your fans are seeing, and that is what is going to give you a lot of support.
Last message for Rashmi fans.
This is a big appeal to all the Rashmi fans, that please support your favorite Rashmi, and she's there battling it out, and I would like to appeal to everyone that just support Rashmi, and let's get her that smile on her face, and let her know that everyone out there is waiting for her to win.
Thank you.